Gentlemen, welcome to this new episode of Sartorial Talks. Today we have the pleasure to welcome you in Milan, in a very special place with a very special guest. The special place is the Segna Bespoke Atelier in Milan, and the special guest is Alessandro Sartori. And Alessandro Sartori is maybe one of the only designers who fill the gap between fashion and classic style. And this is quite a performance because normally these are two worlds which are totally separated, but Alessandro has gained a worldwide reputation. Even the most demanding and traditional tailors in Paris and all around the world have a huge respect for this man. Why? Because first of all, he's a man of the cloth. He's coming from family. His mother was a tailor for women, and he's been trained in the capital city of fabric and textile industry in Italy, which is Biella. And then later, he went on with his studies in design in Milan, and very early, he integrated the Segna company, which is, as you know, the biggest menswear company in the luxury segment. He was the one who transformed the Berluti shoemaker, the famous shoemaker Berluti, into a global brand. And he was the first one to design the Berluti silhouettes for the French market and the international market. And under his leadership, Berluti has been growing as a global brand. The Bespoke Atelier in Segna is something totally new. Can you imagine this company was born in 1910, he started with four looms, can you believe that? And he built, step by step, what we can call today a planetary empire. So thank you, Alessandro, for welcoming us in this very special place. And I have a first question for you. Why did Segna, under your leadership in design, decided to step into the bespoke arena?
First of all, thank you for your time and your fantastic work. And you're not only creating something unique, but mostly this YouTube channel shows that the modernity of our work can really go everywhere with new techniques, and this is really important. As important, going back to your question, for Segna was to create this special atelier. Why? Because we started as a company, Prêt-à-porter, in 1968, and a few years later the company was already doing su misura, which is a single garment created for a single customer using his own ideas translated by the company with special exclusive fabrics, exclusive linings, and an exclusive pattern, but still an industrial garment. We thought with Gildo Segna, when we wanted to relaunch the idea of a modern tailor silhouette for Segna last year, that the best expression of this modern tailoring was bespoke, where you can choose everything from head to toe. We did a fantastic agreement with our friend Gazziano & Gilling in England to produce bespoke shoes through them. And we're selling those shoes here and in London. But mostly we wanted to create what for us is the top of a pyramid of quality with this atelier, which is the interpretation of a Segna fabric through a silhouette, which is totally handmade. Was like to complete a menu, was like to offer a full service, and we see in these first 9 months of work that this atelier has a great success. We attract a lot of customers. Some of them are already customers, others, the most, are new, totally new, and they want to engage a relationship, a conversation with a brand that ends up, as we know, with a beautiful conversation with a master tailor, Mr. Pecora. What I really like about the work that Pecoras are doing was the full experience, how they talk to the customer.
Lo definisco il mio lavoro un lavoro importante per l'azienda dove mi trovo in questo momento. È uno stile che porto dalla Sicilia.
He's saying that his work that has a traditional type of tailoring grounded on the Sicilian roots when he came to Milano very young, and so he's fusing that roots with Milanese style. And in Milano he created his own atelier when he was only 24. And now, after 60 years, he's rejuvenated again with this kind of new experience with Zegna Company. You know, the kind of way and the relationship you like is a very specific thing, and you know how much it's important to go to one tailor or another because you have a beautiful relationship, which is good for you, but needs to be in your own style. These are the reasons why we choose them to work with.
May I say, it's a good choice. I think it's a good choice because Pecora is the guardian of a certain tradition of Milanese bespoke, which is a little bit more structured than in the south of Italy, and I think it's a perfect fit for you. I have another question for you. I would like to discuss with you something which is happening in our world. Basically, the menswear world now has two poles. On one extreme is the casual wear, and on the other extreme is the classic men's style. And in the middle, there was a big market decades ago, which was the people who were buying suit because they had to dress because of their profession, lawyers, bankers. But now, with the casual Friday attitude in the USA, now we have two populations. That is to say, the people who are going more casual because they have the right to go more casual, and also the people who dress classic but by choice and not by obligation. So how do you embrace this enormous movement?
This is a really interesting question, Ugo, because it's not only the evolution of a modern man's wardrobe, but it's also the evolution of the lifestyle of the man we have in mind.
Yes.
We're talking about someone which has good taste, which has a certain education about taste and tailoring and sportswear. And at the same time, this man, which was doing very classic choices before, even for sportswear and formal wear or business wear, today is much more driven by two different, completely different segments, as you well described. First of all, I'm very happy that the bespoke, but also all what is around bespoke, is going extremely well. It means that probably the person we have in mind, which is at the end our ambassador, is not anymore buying as many suits as he was before, but when he's buying suits, he wants his own unique silhouette. So he goes to his tailor like to his barber. He goes to his tailor with a precise idea in mind. He's buying exclusive fabrics. He wants the best of the best. And he's choosing amazing solutions for it. So that idea of the tailoring which is forgotten is completely not true, because actually tailoring never lived such a golden era like today. And this is really beautiful because we keep traditions, we keep human handwork, which is very important,
of course,
and we keep people into this type of business, which are really passing tradition by tradition, generation by generation, a certain education of wearing beautiful style. And this goes from shoes up to shirts, goes from top coat to suits, and so on and so on. On the other way around, the everyday wardrobe is not anymore what it was years ago. Even in that segment, the idea we have of proposing sportswear is what we call couture sportswear. So our tailoring techniques into the sportswear traditions. So is the idea to build a shoulder with a Neapolitan construction, as an example, also in outerwear and in topcoats, not only in shirting or in jackets. Was the idea to give more room to the top of the arm compared to the whole of the chest, also in sportswear. We just did a couple of leather jackets with that technique. Of course, you cannot put 2 centimeters more of leather in the arm compared to the whole, no. But a couple of millimeters, yes.
Yes.
But it means you have to build it by hand, as you do on a sport coat. Also, like beautiful fabric details or leather details on nice cashmere sweaters or cashmere and silk sweaters for summer. So there is a generation of techniques, of traditions, of beautiful tailor-made details that is moving into sportswear garments to enrich the sportswear to the level of tailoring, but with a different silhouette, with different propositions, where knitwear, sport shirts, over jacket or outerwear are more important than before.
I would like to address another subject with you because not every people is aware, are aware about what Zegna represents in this world and the whole approach of this company. Many companies are claiming to be fully integrated, vertical integration, but we can say that Zegna is a vertically integrated a company, and you've gone as far as to have your own farm, if I'm right,
it's true.
Australia,
yes.
And in which you breed some Saxon Merino, which has a very, very high level. Can you tell us a little bit about that?
First of all, what is really interesting about Zegna is that since when the founder started, the idea of integrating the full process was one of the milestones of the company. So buying wool, spinning wool, and then going on the loom and the finishing process by himself. And then the company grew with that philosophy. So when in 1968 we went on Prêt-à-porter, the company went on Prêt-à-porter using his own fabrics. And then the su misura a few years later, and then bespoke this year. And also for the extreme part of this process, for the fashion show, we use our own fabrics and we design our own fabrics into our mill in Trivero. So it's a fully integrated process, not only because we love the idea of working internally, but mostly because we love the idea to design from the beginning. And Akhil Estate is one of the examples. The company wanted to create something which is exclusive, yet right for the time, yet a good product for the final consumer. And today we think that, of course, thin wool or the extreme 13-12 micron wool are the most beautiful type of wool, and they are, because they look like cashmere, at the same time they are wool, they have a performance of a wool, but they are soft as cashmere or even more. What we wanted to create with Akhil, though, was a different philosophy, was the idea of something more organic, where animals are fed in a very sustainable way, where the type of wool we get from that farm, which is Zegna own, is a type of wool that remembers the archive, the heritage, yet in a modern weight. Okay. We all love the beautiful English fabric or the fabric from the archive, and some of the existing English companies are fantastic.
Yes.
We wanted to create our own heritage type of looking wool, but in a lightweight. So the Akhil farm has the type of peculiarity. Mm-hmm. It's particularly, I would say, raw in the way it looks, yet soft and beautiful when you touch. So is a kind of very modern approach to a vintage looking type of wool and fabric, but for a modern suit with a modern weight, which is 250, 280 grams for suits and jackets and not 350 or 400. Mm. It also represents a very interesting episode of a modern collection to me, because going back and asking to our mill of a certain kind of wool, to design a specific fabric that then goes on a kind of suits and jackets and coat, I think is a nice way to intend modern design. We have designers from Lanificio that are working only on this project, as well as a couple of designers in the studio in Milano. So it's a very interesting modern approach. It's a fully integrated design approach.
You just addressed, Alessandro, a very important point. I had many occasions to explain this to different kind of audiences online and even during my lectures. The real big innovation in men's style and menswear of the, let's say, the last decade are not coming only from the designers, and don't take it badly.
No.
But they are coming from the wool industry and from the mills. The fabrics are becoming more and more technical, more and more comfortable, more and more easy to wear, but at the same time, very elegant. I've heard about something that you are developing, and it's already on the market, as far as I know, it's your Tech Merino. And the Tech Merino, for me, if I understand well, can we imagine, Alessandro, that in a few years, or maybe now, I don't know, I can wear my suit, if it's online, for example, and I can, after 2 or 3 days, throw my suit into the washing machine a suit, a bespoke suit even, and then 2 days after put it back and go to work. Is this possible or is it still a dream?
That is really possible today, Ugo. What we did with Tech Merino and with suppliers working with us, because it's a full project that goes from sportswear to jersey, from shirting to suiting, to sport coat to top coats, and to shoes now. So basically, we produce some of the fabrics which are going on suiting, but we have other suppliers working with us on the same yarn and fibers to produce fabrics for shoes, for knitted shoes, and fabric for outerwear. What is really interesting, though, is this idea of bringing wool to the same technical type of attitude and reaction like a synthetic technical fabric.
Yes.
But at the same time, it's natural and fully organic and coming from nature and not synthetic at all. So we were working with our R&D department to think about how the wool fiber can be transformed so well. And if you watch a wool fiber on the microscope, you see that the wool fiber itself is looking like a pineapple tree, because it has all the irregular sides of the surface, which are the one that when you wash it are going together and slippering together, they create the shrinking process, which in the wool finishing we call foldatura.
Okay.
But of course, when you wash at home, if you don't follow the instruction, you have a product which is shrinking like 1, 2, 3 sizes or more. So we were technically working on the fiber, cleaning these different type of edge and creating a kind of regular cylinder on a natural fiber. Mm. And I know other suppliers are working also on the same technique. Probably we went forward than other people. We were able to integrate also the idea of a very fine wool with this process, with the construction of the garments. And we have a generation of, or a wardrobe of product in Tech Merino that today we use from ski suit down to jogger to travel, okay, including a beautiful suit that you can wash in your washing machine. The idea is that actually you travel with your own jacket and suit and you wash as many times you want. I did wash my woolen Tech Merino, so the pettinato version, last summer 3 times.
Mm-hmm.
And I did now, since we did a new flannel, so a winter version of it in this winter season, and actually that one also has been already washed twice. It's looking as it was new. You don't need to iron. So we call wash and go, because actually you don't need to iron and you have a fantastic garment at the end. I think it could be the wool of the future.
That's amazing. This is what I call a revolution in men's style, because maintaining a bespoke suit is, it's a valuable item. It's something that you don't, we all have this strange impression when the cabin crew is putting their hands on your suit. I'm always very nervous. So I've been dreaming a lot of this kind of innovation in fabric. And I know Zegna is really leading the way on this kind of innovation.